I stand here in gratitude, and I stand here as a testimony that being poor, being trafficked, being uneducated is nothing that could stop you to have a purposeful life.
When I finish my study, I would like to be a journalist.
I would like to be a doctor.
I would like to be a pilot.
I would like to be a lawyer.
Thank you.
So those are my girls in the Kakuma refugee camp, which is in Kenya. And they are the first African girls that will learn how to code in the next 10 years. The world out there is very difficult for young women and girls. I started reading and writing when I was 16 years old. Today I'm a full stack developer. I've learned how to code in my local library in Guildford, in the southeast of England, how to code 7 languages. And so all this methodology, all this work I'm doing across the world is pushing me now to go and find 1 million women and girls and teach them how to code by the year 2030. So we do this usually by hackathons and boot camps. We find mentors across the world to get the girls from the Kakuma refugee camp to Argentina and Brazil with Chinese girls who are learning how to code with us. IAM Decode is now one of the biggest movements in the world. I mean, I will say in the world, we're in 64 countries. What we're trying to do is to give young women and girls digital skills. And what is really amazing with the Alibaba partnership is that they'll be the first African girls to have access to the Alibaba cloud and all the software solution Alibaba has. Think about what you can do with your startups. Who are going to be working for you. The only way we can see the next Mariam Jams in the next 10 years is to give people an opportunity. It's time for us, the world, we show empathy, compassion, and kindness for these young women. If we can start giving them digital content at the camp, they can at least start dreaming. You can hire them in the next 10 years. You can do this. Thank you.